So today I wanted to share with you a tasting of Rebel Yell Bourbon. This has been one of my favorite bourbons for a long time, and it's great for mixing with ice, I know. But I've never taken the time to actually taste it properly. So, let's begin. So I'm getting really strong alcohol smell. Normally, again, I drink this with one of those giant balls of ice in a tumbler, and you can't smell any of that. It's perfect for drinking that way. In the Glencairn glass, I'm getting strong alcohol smell and a little bit of vanilla. Yeah. So let's give it a taste. Again, strong alcohol taste and a little bit of vanilla. So the legs on it are really viscous and slow moving, which is kind of surprising to me. Rebel Yell is a very affordable bourbon. It's about $15 for a fifth bottle. And I would expect it to be pretty young. And I believe thick, viscous legs are characteristic of whiskies that have been in the cask a long time. All right, so let's add some water to it. All right, I've added about a straw full of water to this. So if we go back. So the scents I'm getting now are a lot sweeter, something a little fruity. I'm getting a stronger vanilla, a kind of sweet smell. And the smell of berries. It's just a little sour, so I would say blueberries and cream. All right, so one more thing I like to do after adding the water is to place it on a white paper and look. Sometimes these whiskies, the really oily ones, will give you that nice kind of rainbow effect on the top. If you've ever seen, and I'm sure you have, if you've seen motor oil sitting in a puddle in a parking lot, you get that rainbow effect on the top. You get something similar with kind of the oilier whiskies. So let's taste it. So there, the alcohol smell and taste both died down quite a bit. I'm getting actually really strong savory notes, like a pretzel that's been over-salted and over-baked. Yeah, that's what's coming through. The taste lingers for a long time. That salt taste is the last thing to leave. With the water, pretty mild burn. To say mild, I mean negligible. Before the water, the burn was maybe medium in the mouth, disappeared quickly, and then lingered in the throat. All right, so I've given this whiskey some time to chill with the whiskey stones here, and we're gonna see if temperature has an effect on taste. Obviously, ice will have an effect on taste because as ice melts, it adds water to the whiskey. So let's see if just dropping the temperature a little bit opens something new up. I guess I just as easily could have chilled the whiskey. Anyway, yeah, it does seem to have an effect. I'm getting really sweet floral notes here. not a lot of alcohol smell to it. Not unpleasant at all. It's hard to describe. It's a very sweet kind of rose candy smell. Very, I don't know how better to put it. It's, that's good. Maple syrup in there? Yeah, maybe a combination of things. Maple syrup and flowers. Smells really good. Let's try it. Okay, so it's not diluted at all. There is a mild alcohol burn in the mouth. Not bad, really. Virtually none in the throat, though. It's interesting. Still getting very strong savory notes, though. Way over-salted pretzel. That's what I'm getting. So now we're onto the tumbler with a giant ice sphere. Well, as expected, virtually no smell at all. Zero burn. The savory profile's reduced. I didn't add very much whiskey, in my opinion, to the tumbler. But the ice ball is melting very quickly. So this is more watered down than it would be had I just added water directly to it. Launch a bar.